You're listening to the BBM Global Network with 25 years in broadcast audio and video production. Our passionate team creates content and marketing for the world of internet talk radio. If you've got a passion, come join us at bbmglobalnetwork.com. The BBM Global Network. Your voice is now heard.
This is the Mind Health Coach with your host, Leah Marie. Change your mind, change your life. Your life is your choice, and you don't have to walk that path alone. Let Leah help you explore healing, inner peace, self-love, and bring joy and wellness into your life. So now, please welcome the host of the Mind Health Coach, Leah Marie.
Welcome to the Mind Health Coach Program. I'm Leah Marie, your host, and you're listening to a live broadcast here at the BBM Global Network and TuneIn Radio. The Mind Health Coach Program is aired every Monday night from 6 to 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Make sure to tune in to this show on Mondays at 6 p.m. if you want to improve your life. To learn more about me and the programs I offer, you can visit mindhealthcoach.com, and you can also learn more about my 8 weeks to a Better Brain Using Mooditations daily meditation program at mooditations.com. That's mooditations.com. And I'm really happy to be here tonight. I chose to speak about meditation again tonight because I want to talk about the different ways to start your practice of meditation and exploring the inner journey that you can take that connects you to your soul level. A lot of times we run into people that I talk to people quite frequently that are very pessimistic about exploring meditation because they tried what they thought was some form of meditation and they found it too hard or too boring or frustrating and stressful. And, you know, that's part of our culture today, that we don't have patience. We want instant gratification. We want, always be in action, or you feel like you always have to be doing something or you're not being productive. And that is not the case, because I'll tell you, and I've spoke about this quite a few times on the show, I experience so many folks that, at the end of life, or people that have brain illnesses such as Alzheimer's. And, you know, I'm not saying that meditation cures all, but I will say that the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services is stating that it's as important as diet and exercise. And I'll tell you why. Right now, if you're awake and listening and thinking about what I'm saying, you're actually in what's called the beta brainwave state. And that's when we're awake and we're alert and we're comprehending and we're, thinking and thinking about questions and that sort of thing. And what our brain needs to go through different cycles through a 24-hour period. And that's why we need to sleep. You know, most of us cannot survive without sleep. I think there's actually proof, evidence that people that have tried to stay awake for long periods of time, things in their body start to shut down. You know, so we absolutely need to go through the cycle of sleep. Now, what we kind of cheat ourselves of is this alpha brainwave state, and that's where we are in a meditative state. That's really the brainwave level that we need to be at when we're achieving a state of meditation. So what does that mean? What is an alpha brainwave state? Now that I kind of explained the beta brainwave state, the alpha brainwave state is the next step of consciousness. And it's kind of when you are in between, I always like to call it like the spacing out phase. Like say you know, you're sitting there and you're dreaming about, daydreaming about some things, you know, that you want to do. That's kind of an exploration of being in the alpha brainwave state. What we do with that alpha time that our brain is kind of going through is critical to how we are going to perceive our reality, how we are going to be able to handle certain scenarios. And so this is a key time. It's really important and key for us to understand how critical it is in our 24-hour cycle of our days. And, you know, then you have the other brainwave states, which are theta and delta, and those are more focused on the sleep and the rest time for your whole body and your brain. So alpha is something that we're not really, you know, tuned into too often in our day, but we know we might have a few moments that we could have actually negative alpha brainwave states where you're sitting there and you're focused on, oh my gosh, I got to go for this test tomorrow. I have, you know, a possible medical condition that I'm facing. And, you know, I'm going to really sit here and I'm going to just worry. And that's not going to serve you. That's not going to be helping you in that present moment or even going forward through the rest of your day till you get to that test. It's actually probably going to stir up some inflammation because you're going to sit there and you're going to call in the things that cause inflammation into your body. So I'm talking from a very physiological standpoint right now where you're sitting there, you're having these stress thoughts, and you're bringing in this experience that you don't even know what it's going to be like. You know, it's like you're not even aware of if it's going to be painful, if it's going to be a positive outcome, if it's going to be a resolution to your fears of what potentially is on the horizon for you medically. It could resolve all of that. And instead, you're sitting there worrying about, oh, you know, I might have some serious illness. I have to go to this test. You know, the doctor might do the procedure and it's painful. And, you know, that's where you're setting up a lot of the negativity, and it's producing, typically you'll be producing cortisol through your body. So cortisol is a hormone that brings in a level of inflammation. I talk about it almost every show because I think we all have to be aware of how much cortisol and inflammation that we're causing in our bodies and bringing into our system. And the reason why I feel like we need to understand that more and understand how our thoughts can just you know, instantly bring in this destructive hormone that can affect so many parts of our body. It can also affect our brain health. You know, that's why I like to kind of educate about it. So cortisol has to be used for our bodies when we are in a state of, you know, having a virus that we need to fight, or maybe, you know, we're having some sort of dramatic situation that's happening that we need the endorphins to come in and help us get ourselves out of sticky situations. But when we're always producing it, when we're always having the chronic cortisol, it causes chronic inflammation, which brings on disease. So dis-ease. And how do we combat that in this? In this life today, we're totally immersed in, like I initially said, instant gratification. We're being bombarded by a lot of different energy all the time because we are always accessible now. You know, 99% of the population is, you know, having a cell phone on their hip or, you know, in their pocketbook, and anybody can reach you at any time. And if you aren't picking up, people get nervous, people get worried, your job might be on the line. There's a lot of components that, you know, you have to make yourself that accessible unless you tell everybody I'm going off the grid. And I actually did that a couple weeks ago. Was it last weekend? Yes, not this past weekend, but the weekend before, I went off the grid. I went to a workshop at Omega, and which is a wonderful holistic studies institute out in Rhinebeck, New York. And I just really like decided that I was going to immerse myself in the experience. I already had pretty bad cell service, so I just cut all communications to the outside world, and I really got into a space of, you know, being there and being present, which was really wonderful for me. So I just took that time, and it was a reminder of, okay, wow, you know, I was able to shut off from me being distracted from this present moment, which allowed me to be, you know, more in the moment to actually get into alpha brainwave state. So we actually have to take a quick break. And when we come back, you know, the focus tonight is going within on an inner journey and, you know, having the healing from that. And what are the ways we can explore that? So we'll be right back. Stay tuned.
Are you looking for employment and live in Los Angeles, Orange, Riverside, and San Bernardino counties? Jobs Annex is the place for you. Are you an employer looking to fill a position or quite a few positions in Los Angeles, Orange, Riverside, and San Bernardino counties? Jobs Annex is for you. Employers, JobsAnnex.com is your resource for career-minded people. JobsAnnex.com is the convenient place for job seekers and employers to hook up and move forward. Jobs Annex has been serving Los Angeles, Orange, Riverside, and San Bernardino counties for over 14 years. Jobs Annex is a former employment search firm. We've evaluated many thousands of resumes, and we understand what employers want and what job applicants need to be successful in their interviews. At Jobs Annex, we provide you with the tools to tell your story for free. Our resources at JobsAnnex.com will help each applicant construct an award-winning resume, an eye-catching cover letter, and key interview questions to ask in various types of interviews. Best of all, it's free. JobsAnnex.com. That's JobsAnnex.com.
There are artists, and then there's Alice Asmar. This award-winning artist has spent her entire life devoted to her artistic pursuits and has had a lifelong fascination with American Indians of the southwestern United States. Her book, Dance to the Great Spirit, showcases her drawings and paintings inspired by sacred rituals of the Pueblo Indians, and four of her lithographs are in permanent collection at the National Museum of American History and the Smithsonian Institution in Washington, D.C. She is one of four artists in the United States to win a Woolley Fellowship for study in Paris at L'École des Beaux-Arts and has been featured in numerous publications. She's exhibited at the world's most prestigious museums and galleries and recently won a 20-year service award from the Burbank City Council and the inaugural art competition of the Foundation of the United States in Paris.
Visit www.asmarart.com, www.aliceasmarinternational.com, and email Alice at aliceasmar@aol.com.
We're back, and I'm Leah Marie, your host for this hour on the BBM Global Network and TuneIn Radio with the Mind Health Coach Program. So before we went to break, I was talking about my, well, it's like a passion of mine, actually, meditation and the practices of being present. And, you know, I love to explore meditation. I know it turns some people off, you know, but it's really important that you know how to do it correctly. You know, it's very simple once you understand what you're trying to achieve. And that's basically, you know, shutting off like all of the outside stuff that's going on. Unless that is your experience that you want to have, you know, sometimes, like I said, there's so many different methods of meditation that you can actually take in the exterior environment and utilize it to help you focus and, you know, being in that alpha brainwave state. I love to go in nature, like go to the beach or, you know, be in any nature spot where I'm sitting on a big giant, you know, rock in the middle of the woods and listening to the birds and the leaves and the trees making their wonderful noises. It's an experience in itself, and just tuning in and just being part of that flow can be unbelievable, and it can be like you're feeling really at one with the universe. And so meditation has many different styles. You don't have to just be stuck on, oh, I can't do it because I, you know, sat quiet one day and I just had all these thoughts and, you know, that was enough for me to decide meditation's not for me. You know, I have mentioned this fact quite a few times in the past about that if you meditate every day for 12 to 27 minutes, I know that's a weird number, but that's what Harvard came up with. A researcher at Harvard University came up with, Dr. Sarah Lazar, I think is the researcher's name. 12 to 27 minutes per day, you start to grow gray brain matter in the areas of learning, language, and compassion. And you start to also build new neural networks. So like your neurotransmitters will build different roadways. So it all depends, though, on what's the premise of your experience. Like I mentioned before we went to break, if you're sitting there and you're knee deep in worry, or you're waist deep in it, or you're up to your neck in it, that's not going to be effective. That's actually going to, you know, inspire you to start thinking and focusing more on the negative. What the practice of mindfulness is bringing you back to the present moment and realizing that in that moment, everything is okay. You know, you're immersed in whatever it is you are experiencing. And that's why it's great to put yourself into a space like nature or at the beach or, you know, with some aromatherapy going on or incense burning, because that will bring about those feelings and emotions that will help you feel positive. It'll bring in the positive energy. That's where you want to be at. You don't want to be having those stress thoughts. You want to focus on a positive mantra, even if you're not feeling it. Like, just go through the acting of it and smile. And, you know, it's not always easy. I know I've been there where you're forcing yourself to do this positive thing, like, you know, say a positive statement over and over again, a positive affirmation, and you're not really feeling it. But if you start saying it enough and you start thinking about the words, the energy of that starts to shift things even slightly. And before you know it, you're kind of gliding into positivity with it, you know, and you're feeling good. There's going to be moments where you're still challenged with those negative feelings and you're saying, oh, I got to go, you know, fake it again. I've got to put that smile on and fake that positivity again and fake that I feel okay inside. But I know that once I start working on that, I will reach that. And I heard somebody say recently to me in a workshop that, your emotions, if you let them float by, if you just kind of let them flow, I'm not saying you just start yelling at people if you're angry and that sort of thing. I'm saying if you have an emotion inside and you know that it's a negative one, you can let it sit for a moment and experience it and honor it, and then you can let it go. And it takes about 2 minutes to let it go. And if you need tools, we've got that. You know, we've got the aromatherapy, which is wonderful for that. We've got EFT, emotional freedom technique, which is wonderful. Tapping on different acupuncture points, deep breathing, bringing in positive energy. All these things can help you shift that perspective so that you can get back in the good flow, the positive energy flow. So with that being said, you know, what are some different things that you can do during your meditation practice that will help you go within? If you're struggling, if you're having a difficult time, you're trying to meditate and just sitting there and trying to, you know, block out everything on the outside isn't working for you, which, you know, it is very hard for especially a newbie trying to get into developing a daily meditation practice to just sit there and, you know, be quiet. Especially if you're a very busy person, that's going to be like very frustrating. And so there's a wonderful book that I always recommend so that you can understand that, no, you're not like, you're not unique. You're not, well, we all are unique, but you're not, a damaged meditator that can never meditate. You actually are experiencing what a lot of us go through when we're instituting this practice. And this book is really great. Like I said, it will explain to you the different feelings and emotions and the stages of meditation. And it's called The 21 Stages of Meditation. And it's written by Gurusharan Singh Khalsa, who's a PhD. And it's just a really great format because you can kind of go through that. And it helps you also identify different, you know, mudras that you can do, poses, to help you focus. And so, you know, when you're doing a pose, like you're holding your hands a certain way, which is a mudra, you're really like having to focus on different things than any negative thought. You're actually like, you're using your fine motor skills. You're doing some deep breathing. You're focused on the breath. You're focused on the way your body is positioned and you're holding that space. And you're kind of, you're trying to get into this. So it's like, it's not faking it, but it's forcing the energy to happen from where you're positioned. So that's a wonderful way to, you know, practice that mindfulness and being present, because you're using all of these skills. You're in the present moment, you're working at it, and you're actually meditating if you're, you know, able to just shift your focus on these positions and being in the space. That's being mindful of where what you're doing with your body in that moment. And you know you're doing something positive for yourself if you're focusing on these types of things. So this is all going to create positive energy and the endorphins that come in and the joy that comes in when you can succeed is just, it's a wonderful thing. When we come back, we're going to take a short break. When we come back, I'm going to talk about many other styles of meditation that you can explore. Before we go, I just want to state that I have a guided meditation CD, and it's also available in MP3s, available at my website, mindhealthcoach.com. So go check that out. Stay tuned. We'll be right back and talking about ways to meditate and expand your practice.
The earliest human societies worshipped a female goddess. Little is known about this time because we did not always have a written recorded history. It was around 3100 BC when the Sumerians invented the first written language, and everything that preceded this time is prehistory. The prehistorical record includes all of women's unwritten history from 30,000 BC to the time that men began achieving political power around 3000 BC. Male feminist artist Kimberly Berg maintains a strong position in educating and inspiring both men and women through his devotional art to the goddess in all women. Studying their history is paramount to understanding who women were and who they would become later, living in a patriarchal society. To learn more about this important time in our history, go to www.isisrising.net. Animal lover, author, artist, and public speaker, Patricia Daly Leip is a Renaissance woman in her own right. A lover of animals from a young age, Patricia lives on a farm in Virginia and has rescued neglected thoroughbred horses, keeping them or finding them safe havens. She is also a published author, and her books document real-life experiences that she shares in her passionate stories, taking the reader around the world in a colorful kaleidoscope of life. An accomplished artist, Patricia Daly Leip's oil paintings feature animals, portraits, stills, nature, and abstract, and she allows the brush to paint the image in an organic, natural way. A public speaker, Patricia is motivated to continually wonder about life and advocates for all of us to do the same and document our own unique history. To learn more about Patricia Daly Leip, visit www.literarylady.com and www.patricialeip.com or email her at pdleip@gmail.com.
Welcome back to the Mind Health Coach program with Leah Marie on BBM Global Network and iTunes Radio. We are talking tonight about meditation, and, you know, I kind of described the health benefits, you know, that it helps build your brain, you know, and it literally is fitness for your brain. So if you know anything about Alzheimer's disease, you know, the brain before Alzheimer's disease actually weighs about 3 pounds. So anybody, you know, that has a healthy brain, it's about 3 pounds. You know, when you're going through the disease process, it's affecting your brain and it's taking away the brain matter. And, you know, your brain at the end is actually about 1.5 pounds. So you lose half the mass, like you lose a lot of your brain matter during a disease process like that. I'm not sure of the effects when you're in the disease process, how that can help, you know, slow it down or anything like that. I'm not saying that, you know, meditation is going to resolve it. But I have heard a lot of research and studies being done for the preventative measures. And I have a great I have a great link on my website on the blog page that gives you a whole lifestyle protocol on how to really dementia-proof your brain. And it was a study that was done by UCLA where, you know, you do 20 minutes of yoga, 20 minutes of meditation, you eliminate processed foods. And I've talked about this many times, but I am so passionate because I see these folks with Alzheimer's that are, you know, really suffering. And my team is caring for these people at the end. And I just want to do all I can to help people understand that, you know, as a society, you know, right now the statistics are, I can't say that word for some reason, one in two people over 85 have Alzheimer's. And, you know, that's very serious. One in two people over 85 have Alzheimer's. And if we can work on the way our culture is so that we can prevent that, because our culture has it the worst in the world, it seems like it's very prevalent in our culture. It is also in other countries, obviously, but our culture's hit hard with it. It's an epidemic. If we can do anything, you know, just simply meditating is awesome for us to just implement in a daily practice. So, you know, I have been studying this new program that I'm really excited about. And I've been learning about primordial sound meditation. And primordial sound meditation is something that is based on a mantra that it is based on the sounds of the universe and the rhythms of the universe. And it's just unbelievable, the power of that. And each rhythm of the universe and sound of the universe is recorded. And apparently they did this many years ago in ancient times. The sages recorded all the sounds of the universe, and there was 108 different sounds of the universe. And so each of us has our own mantra that's connected to this primordial sound of the universe. And it's just amazing because you can determine it through your birth date and, you know, where you were placed on the planet, how all of the moon, the stars, all the planets were aligned at the time of your birth. So when you came from being in the womb out, and you're now being, you know, in the world, of the world, that is what your mantra would be based on, in that time and space and the sound of the universe at that time. And you can focus on that sound of the universe at that time that you were birthed. And you can focus on that mantra that represents that. And it doesn't really like have meaning or whatever, but it's just amazing what that power can do. And I've been doing it. I've been doing it 30 minutes a day, you know, sometimes twice a day. I do it in the morning and the evenings. And just the meaning of that the sound of the universe at the time of my birth that I'm focusing on is so powerful. It's like I just feel so empowered by that sound. And I feel like a lot of things are, you know, I like to tap into my esoterical thinking sometimes. And I feel like there's more coming in and, you know, that I'm being delivered messages. And, you know, like yesterday I saw a cardinal like three times in different places. And, you know, that's like an animal messenger to me. You know, I'm very into checking on the meaning of what that is. And, you know, it was really interesting because it spoke to what I was feeling. And it's like that you're growing in more power, that you're, you know, and your messages are coming in from spirit. So it was pretty significant to me. I felt, oh, you know, there's a total confirmation of what the energy I'm putting out in, you know, in my meditation of the primordial sound meditation. And, you know, that is coming back to me as okay, we're hearing that you're working on this, and we're showing you that, you know, we're grateful, and, you know, we're giving you more of more power, but I am feeling more life force. I'm feeling more energy. And I think that's quite significant, you know, and I think that's really a key for me to keep going with that meditation for a while. And always, I mean, I really will always, once I start doing certain practices in my study of meditation and exploration, I start to, you know, fold it in and make it part of the the schedule. So, you know, I do meditate a few times a day. You know, I definitely will try to get in a morning and evening. And then, you know, at some point in the day, if I'm feeling any stress, I do another meditation. And they're just minutes long. You know, they're not real lengthy. Although, like I said, I've been committed to doing the half hour primordial sound meditation every day and trying to do it twice a day. And it's really phenomenal. And, you know, there's just so many different styles that you can practice. There's other ones that you can go within. You know, that's what the whole experience is to go within so that you're tapping into your inner being, in your inner spark, your inner divine spark, which is your soul, which is connected to, you know, if you have a belief system of a higher power, which I really do, and I know a lot of people do. And it's surprising because I grew up in a family where both my parents were atheists. So I always felt like I was in some TV show or something, that I got placed in the wrong family. And, you know, maybe this is like some sort of joke, you know, like the Truman Show or whatever that movie was. I just feel that I have had some prior connection to why I really have this strong belief in a higher power. But I, like I said, I really enjoy when I have those moments of like seeing a cardinal and then looking up the meaning and how it connects to a different spiritual practice that I've been implementing. I really that excites me. That really, you know, brings me a lot of enthusiasm and happiness and joy, inner peace. So we need to take another quick break. And when we get back, I'm still going to approach the topic of many different styles of meditation. I hope you guys are learning about, you know, what might interest and intrigue you on your journey of inner exploration. We'll be right back.
Intergenerational programming is uniting America due to the tireless efforts of Dr. Ramona Frischman. Retired from the Miami-Dade County Public School System, Dr. Frischman continues to develop intergenerational learning programs aimed to improve the lives of children, young adults, and seniors through unique strategies and public policy in order to establish a mutually supportive agenda. She views intergenerational programs as a resource for policymakers and the general public on economic, social, and personal initiatives that govern our society. Her work bridges the generational gap, providing many individuals the opportunity to explore areas of common ground and celebrate each other's diversity. Contact Ramona Frischman at ramonalong@aol.com or visit www.gu.org to learn more about intergenerational programming.
Do you battle with weight loss? There is a solution. Founder of Weight No More Consulting, Deborah Simons, can help you lose weight safely and effectively through weight loss surgery. I know. I had the surgery 2 years ago, and I am 135 pounds lighter and medication-free. This full-service weight loss center caters to your every need as you navigate to a healthy weight following surgery. Servicing all of Canada, Weight No More Consulting takes pride in its compassionate care and guides you through each step before and after surgery. Starting with informational meetings, Weight No More Consulting educates each potential client before they decide to have surgery on the health risks of obesity and the various weight loss surgeries available. After surgery, Weight No More Consulting provides a solid support system with ongoing meetings to ensure continued success. Deborah Simons and Weight No More Consulting are committed to promoting your health and wellness through maintaining a healthy weight for life.
Welcome back to the Mind Health Coach Program with Leah Marie on BBM Global Network and iTunes Radio. Before we went to break, I, you know, was talking about meditation and the different affirmations that I've been receiving from implementing a new practice. And I've been meditating for probably 15 years or more. Yeah, it's probably been about 17, 18 years. So I am always finding new ways to meditate. I just, like I said, it brings me so much joy to really take that alpha brainwave state seriously. And as part of my 24-hour period of how I need to live healthy. And that includes making sure I get enough sleep. You know, that's really critical too to our well-being. And, you know, it's not just do, go. You need to make sure you're taking that time to kind of just be in a state of awareness, but inner awareness too. And so I got really excited about this practice I've recently implemented, the primordial sound meditation. And, you know, I talk a lot about meditation, and sometimes I forget, you know, that folks aren't really aware of the different things, the different options. They just, you know, I do a lot of speaking to the medical field. So when I speak, I talk in terms of how it helps your brain and, you know, some different practical things that you can do, but I don't really dive in deep. I haven't done some of my classes in a little while where I did 8 different weeks of different styles of meditation. And that is so much fun. Like, I can't wait to do that again. I actually am going to be doing that in the coming year for the Alzheimer's Association. I'm going to do in Massachusetts some different classes about different styles of meditation. So I'm really, really excited about that. So, you know, the health benefits are unbelievable because you can actually lower your blood pressure. You can actually, you know, perceiving your reality different is important because sometimes we have so many different thoughts that impact the way that we're perceiving our reality that it impacts our health in the long run. So, you know, autoimmune disorders can become activated because the inflammation, the chronic inflammation in your body is happening. So there's all these different reasons why you should look at taking this time for yourself and making sure that you're utilizing alpha brainwave state in a positive, healthy way, which is meditation, you know, and being present. So there's different styles, like I mentioned, the primordial sound meditation, which is a mantra, and it's your own personal mantra that you receive when you are born. So it's kind of, you have to consult with somebody that is, you know, knows how to identify that. And so I'm looking into actually doing the coursework on that. And so I may be able to be certified. So keep in touch if that's something you're interested in. Send me your email, and you can actually sign up for my email newsletter at mindhealthcoach.com. You go to the contact page and you submit your information there. Or if you have a question you want to ask me directly, or you want to set up a session, you can go to my website, mindhealthcoach.com, and do that. You can also email me at info@mindhealthcoach.com. You know, can join me on Facebook. I'm there on Facebook, Leah Marie, the Mind Health Coach. So there's other different practices that you can look at. Yoga Nidra is a wonderful practice for deep relaxation and healing. And I remember conducting a class I taught at UMass in Dartmouth, Massachusetts, UMass University of Massachusetts. And I did a Yoga Nidra class. And, you know, some people found it to be, you know, not exciting enough. And some people were like, this is it for me. This is what I want to do to meditate. This is exactly what I needed. So Yoga Nidra is developed by somebody named Richard Miller, and there's some books on it. You can actually get a CD, and he guides you through your body, like the sensations that are happening, like what is happening in your mouth and what is happening, you know, in each part of your body. How is it feeling? And comparing, you know, different things, different sensations, and, you know, the right side to the left side. So it is a total exploration on the physical level, and then it gets to the mental level, but it's, you know, a very unique experience, and it does take some time. Like the meditation itself that comes with the book that I have is about an hour long. So, and it takes that time to really get immersed in that experience and feel the benefits, but it is like you are on cloud 9 and you feel totally relaxed after doing Yoga Nidra. And it's very powerful because that is creating, like I had mentioned previously in the previous segment, it is creating and setting up in your brain a whole different network of the way you're thinking. So like you're perceiving things different and your body is so relaxed, you might not be so stressed out about something that was really stressing you out. Like I mentioned, you know, maybe having to go for a medical test or something, you do a session of Yoga Nidra, you get really inside and you start feeling, you know, the healing from that, and you start feeling so relaxed and you're like ready to go to that procedure. You know, you're like, okay, I can handle this. I'm ready. You know, and even during the procedure, you might do this practice of yoga nidra and, you know, focus on other parts of your body while the doctor is working on whatever part it is that, you know, that they need to do a test on. So that can help you in such, you know, positive ways to know this type of practice and to actually be practicing it before you go in and have something like that done. In the summertime, I had to have a PICC line put in, you know, and that's not fun. I had it put into my arm. I had Lyme disease and spinal meningitis, which was pretty, you know, scary because that you could die from that stuff. So, you know, they sent me, you know, I was in the hospital for a week and then they sent me home with a PICC line. And, you know, that's a wonderful thing because you can actually self-administer your antibiotics and get really healed. And, you know, I am incredibly healthy now. I feel wonderful. Like I said, my life force is back in me and I really contribute it to the meditation. I had to meditate during that process though, because you are awake when they're putting this PICC line in and it's like going to a valve in your heart. So it's pretty serious stuff that they're sneaking into your, you know, through a vein or an artery or whatever. And I, even the thought of that was difficult for me. So I had to seriously focus on different things. And I used, you know, yoga nidra was really powerful for me at that time. You know, it just goes to say too, when you're focusing on things that you know are coming that are difficult and you're focusing on them in the most positive light, you're actually shifting the energy and it's not, you know, it's just the whole experience becomes so much easier for you. So, not just at the physical moment of it, but just the thinking of it can shift so much that you're not so worried about things. So we're going to take another break and we're going to continue our exploration on meditation when we come back.
Certified professional coach Pamela Reeves can help you with your relationships. Motivational and image coaching are just some of the ways she can help you enhance all aspects of your life. Her book, Is It Love or Merely a Sick Attachment?, helps readers clearly distinguish healthy, loving relationships from toxic ones. Ms. Reeves has put her words into action through Ray of Hope Kenya, an international initiative that provides outreach to victims of abusive relationships there with the goal of helping them rebuild their lives and the tools to avoid abuse. Ms. Reeves operates various business interest through her umbrella network, Nella LLC, and credits her success to her diverse work experience. Whatever your goals, whether striking a balance, reinventing your image, or simply lifting your lifestyle, Pamela Reeves will help you achieve them. Your life, your call. Dial 410-902-5715 or email Pamela at pamregeo1@verizon.net. She's also on the web at pamreeves.com and on Twitter at Pamela_Reeves.
My Dreams, My Challenges, and Joys is an inspiring book by author Linda Genazzo. This real-life account of raising a child with autism from birth to adulthood takes you on a journey of compassion, love, and hope as it tells the incredible story of a devoted family and their beloved daughter. Together, they faced adversity and never stopped believing they would find the help they were seeking. A breast cancer survivor, Linda Genazzo has a giving heart. With a background in social work with the mentally ill and the homeless, Linda continues to help families in her community. And her book, My Dreams, My Challenges and Joys, brings greater awareness to autism and those families in need. To purchase your copy, visit www.lindagenazzo.com. It's also available on amazon.com and barnesandnoble.com. Don't delay. Get your copy today.
We're back on the Mind Health Coach program with Leah Marie on BBM Global Network and iHeartRadio. Tonight, we're discussing the very important topic of meditation. And I know that a lot of people have tried it or, you know, thought they've tried it. And, you know, it's not that big of a deal to sit down and, you know, do some deep breathing. And people feel like, oh, yeah, I did that. And, you know, I'm all set with that. But when you know the impacts of how it can help you avoid different diseases, such as autoimmune disorders caused by inflammation in the body, and it also has been proven that it can prevent certain DNA that's you know, probably like an autoimmune disorder or something genetic, to be turned on if you are managing through meditation, you actually can avoid turning on some of that DNA that can bring on autoimmune disorder. So it's extremely powerful medicine, meditation. If you put the two words of meditation and medication together, and I'm not advocating that you throw out your medication, because believe me, as I said, I went through some pretty tough stuff in the Lyme disease disease process. And, I also had another tick-borne illness called babesia. So I've experienced that, and I had to have the medications as the acute portion of it. But the way I've been able to improve my health so quickly is focusing on the holistic practices that I do, as well as, doing these things such as meditation. And it really is powerful. It's powerful to help yourself in that way, along with using, the medicine that we have developed in our culture in America, working with the doctors. I had a fabulous care team, I want to say, too. I was so grateful for all they did for me when I was sick in June. So more about exploration on meditation. I wanted to read a page from The Course in Miracles by Karen Casey. It's a daily meditation. Daily Meditations for Practicing the Course by Karen Casey. I love this book. It's helped me change my perspective on so many issues that were really, really tough for me to swallow. And I've been forced to face illness. I've been through divorce. I've lost a parent, had tremendous grief there, have had a lot of different scenarios where this book has helped me see things in a different light. So I just wanted to read this one page that I just kind of opened it up, and this kind of happens a lot when I do that. I'll find a topic that is very helpful. So it's on the topic of forgiveness, and so many of us hold on to anger and, other disruptive things that can affect us. So this is an example of reading a passage from a book and then focusing on, like, this particular one has an affirmation, and it's something you can focus on in your meditation. So forgiveness in this world is the equivalent to love in heaven. That's what the topic of this particular passage is. So why is it so hard to forgive others' character defects? Not only do we resist forgiving them, we contemplate aggressive punishment in many cases. We have been told by other course students, and that's A Course in Miracles, that in reality we cower from forgiving ourselves. And when we finally forgive ourselves, we discover that our resentments towards others have been dissipated as well. Why are we so hard on ourselves and consequently others? It's owing to the guilt we feel for having exchanged God's world for this painful and silly charade. In that one insane moment, we refused God's unconditional love, and this nightmare is the result. We don't relish remaining here because the anxiety is so great, but the ego puts up a struggle every time we choose to honor God's memory. Fortunately, God placed Holy Spirit in our minds when we escaped. That's our ticket back. In time, we will make the final journey home. So the affirmation in this whole passage is, I am on a mission today to return to my real home. I will contemplate the memory of God that is within me. So forgiveness is the world. Forgiveness in this world is equivalent to the love in heaven. So forgiveness, when you're letting go of forgiveness, when you're, seeing it for what it is and just letting it go, you're actually doing so much better for yourself when you are in a state of forgiveness on a really tough topic. Because when you're holding yourself in anger, it's bringing in those, those bad hormones that I talked about, cortisol and everything. So it's affecting you physically. It affects your reality when you're angry and, feeling resentment towards someone. It brings in a lot of negativity, and on a physical level as well as an emotional level. And it's really affecting you more than it is anything else. So it's important to forgive for yourself. It doesn't mean that you're going to go be friends or anything like that, but just the practice of forgiveness and in a state of, knowing that it's just between you and God. That's kind of what that whole reading was about. So why did I bring that up? Well, it's like you're you're thinking about that passage when you can do that too. You don't have to just sit there in meditation and just, you know, close out every thought. There are meditations that involve thought. So that particular practice of meditation, reading something, would be exploring the thought of forgiveness and how it make you feel if you didn't have that negative thinking going on, because you wanted to be in a state of pure love, which means you're in divine love. And divine love allows you to love from afar. You don't have to be right up in anybody's face. You don't have to be, you know, fighting with somebody, arguing with somebody. You can love from a distance. And, you know, that energy of love that's sent in that way, you know, when I've done this practice many times, when I am, you know, really upset with somebody, the way I shift it in myself and forgive, even if I never have contact or whatever with that person again, is that I will allow divine love to come through me and channel out to that person. And I will allow that channel of love to flow through me, so it's healing both of us at the same time. And when I know that I'm healed, when I feel that I'm healed, I know that on some level I'm healing everybody. And not only that person, but everybody's being touched by that, because I'm feeling better. And when we feel better, everybody around us is feeling better. And it's like a ripple effect. So when we come back, we got to take another quick break. And when we come back, I'm going to wrap it up. I'm going to talk quickly about a few other self-exploration techniques through meditation. But I do want to ask, if you're interested in A Course in Miracles and, you know, opening up to it and being in a state of a student and that sort of thing, email me, because I have been thinking about doing an online course. I have taught it in person, but I'd love to do A Course in Miracles online, and I'd love to, you know, grow a community of people that are interested in learning it. So email me at info@mindhealthcoach.com. We'll be right back.
MJ Domit is the owner of Expect to Be Empowered, a company whose specialty is empowering people to live their best life by following their heart and accepting themselves unconditionally. After studying and making personal changes, MJ now focuses on giving others tools for self-empowerment. She provides individual and group workshops for people who are physically, emotionally, and spiritually blocked. Inspired by her work at Expect to Be Empowered, MJ authored the book Waves of Blue Light, Heal the Heart and Free the Soul, with accompanying empowerment cards. She is a Spirit Book of the Year Gold Medal Living Now Book Award winner. And her book is a number one Amazon bestseller in spirituality and was a 2012 Gold Medal winner, recognized as the Living Now Spirit Book of the Year. An inspirational speaker, MJ will show you how you can repurpose every area of your life. Your life did not just happen to you. You chose it, which means you can change it. Visit www.expecttobeempowered.com or call 866-264-8024.
Introducing BetterHomeAndGarden.com. That's www.betterhomeandgarden.com with just the letter N in Better Home and Garden. BetterHomeAndGarden.com offers you the highest quality products on the market that are environmentally safe and effective, and to make them available to you at the lowest possible prices. BetterHomeAndGarden.com understands that kind of creativity and do-it-yourself attitude. Thus, we developed our website, BetterHomeAndGarden.com. BetterHomeAndGarden.com offers you the following products right online: bath, bedding, collectibles, craft, sewing and hobby, food and beverage, furniture, home decor, kitchen and dining, lamps and lighting, large appliances, musical instruments, outdoor cooking, patio items, pet supplies, plant and garden, rug and floor covering, small appliances, travel and luggage, and so much more. Better Home and Garden is an online retailer offering a wide variety of high-quality brand-name merchandise at discount prices. Our service is personal, and we aim to please. Visit us at www.betterhomeandgarden.com. Make your home your own.
Thanks so much for everyone tuning in to the Mind Health Coach program tonight. I'm Leah Marie, your host, and tonight we were talking about the different explorations that you can do, the study of meditation to go within, and how important it is to your health to take that time, because it's not just, you know, like an outward thing. It's not like, oh, I meditate and that's it. This actually impacts your health, the way you perceive your reality, on the long term. And, you know, some people think, oh, you know, I can meditate and feel great. And, you know, it actually is shifting the way you think when you are doing these practices. So it's like planting a seed. The soil is very fertile at the time of alpha brainwave state, and you're growing it as you meditate. It grows and it filters out, and it it bleeds out into the rest of your every part of your life. And it's pretty amazing, the healing effects on a physical, emotional, spiritual level, you know, all of that. It's just amazing what can happen in your life. So as you can see, I'm a big advocate of meditation. There are so many other things and tools that if you want to spice it up and have fun with meditation and your study of meditation, there's crystals you can work with and looking at the healing properties and focusing on the healing properties as you hold a crystal like amethyst. If you're feeling, you know, you need some healing, amethyst is a great, powerful crystal. And you can add, I just picked up a African white quartz crystal, and I was reading that it really is one of the most powerful magnifiers of whatever your thoughts are and what your connection is to your higher self. So, you know, I love combining two crystals because I would bring both those energies together. So healing and magnification, very powerful. There's also fun things to do in nature, like looking and observing and seeing what signs you're seeing. Like I saw the cardinal. So I looked up the meaning of cardinal, and then I did a meditation after. What do those key things mean to me? Powerful and, you know, bringing different empowerment things to my life. So there's so many things you can do that are very interesting. And, you know, this is a study of you. This is all about you and what's happening inside and how to achieve inner peace, powerful healing, and, you know, bringing in that love that we all want to touch our souls, that we want to be emanating, you know, love in our lives, and we want to experience love. That's what our needs are very much based around, that love, that energy of love. So when you're in that state of meditation, you're practicing daily, you're doing these things, loving yourself, taking that time, self-care, it's very, very powerful. So, you know, there's so many different things with different books out there. I myself have guided meditations. If you're new at this and you need somebody to kind of paint a picture for you, I have some wonderful guided meditations on my website, mindhealthcoach.com. And please email me. Like I said, I want to talk about offering a Course in Miracles webinar or, you know, forum for community to be built online. And I'd love to hear feedback from all of you around the world that listen to this show. So again, my name is Leah Marie. I'm the Mind Health Coach. You can find out more about me at mindhealthcoach.com. Please email me at info@mindhealthcoach.com and also schedule a session. Look out at the products on there. Check out my meditations. And I will see you next Monday night. Thank you.
You've been listening to The Mind Health Coach with your host, Leah Marie. Tune in each week so you can experience contentment and a feeling of well-being on all levels of existence, physical, mental, emotional, and spiritual, on The Mind Health Coach Show with your host, Leah Marie.
You've been listening to the BBM Global Network. The ideas, views, and opinions of this broadcast are those of the participants of the program and are not necessarily the ideas, views, and opinions of the BBM Global Network Company.